struck many firsts during its career. It was the first operational jet in service with the Royal Air Force. It was the first operational jet in service with the Allies. Flying bombs and meteors downed 13 of them. From the outset, it was a rugged and reliable aircraft. Power comes from a pair of Rolls-Royce Derwent turbojets, which became standard from the 16th example of the Meteor Mark III onwards. The early prototypes and early production examples having used a variety of different engines. And they're a very elegant view of the two-seat trainer. The exploits of the Meteor were, of course, a source of much pride to Britain. In 1945 and 46, modified Meteors set new outright world airspeed records. And through into the 1950s, the Meteor F-8 became the standard day fighter of RAF Fighter Command, and the T-7, like we see here, the standard jet trainer in the RAF's advanced flying schools. In fact, it was the RAF's first jet trainer. Also night fighter variants, all built by Armstrong Whitworth, in which role the Meteor replaced the de Havilland Mosquito. By that time, the addition of heavy airborne intercept radar in the aircraft's lengthened nose was taking the weight of the machine rather beyond the initial design specifications, but there were no commensurate increases in the aircraft's power, so performance rather suffered. Stable gun platform, good for ground attack missions. This T-7 at Mon. So a meteor coming into land. I mentioned that it's been possible with this trainer version to do pilot training, and the man at the control stay is the